good morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports on this cloudy, gray Wednesday. Happy hump day. I anticipate a rain of goals. I anticipate a rain of goals on this gray, gray Thursday. The Champions League is back. The Champions League return with bangers upon bangers, cliff hangers. And once again, Harry Kane is adding up to his numbers. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports. The Champions League return with games, mouth-watering clashes. But it has raised concern about the quality of the game after the whole restructure, the new format, the new formula. So many games were played yesterday. More are going on today. The marquee game was obviously the Liverpool against AC Milan at the San Siro. Arne Slot and his boys went there and got the job done. The defending from AC Milan, but it has been an underlining, should I say, theme across Europe this weekend. Even in the Premier League, the North London Derby, it was a defensive blunder. The game against Liverpool and AC Milan, if you watch it with a critical eye, almost amateurish, how they gave up those goals after Christian Pulisic gave them a splendid goal in the first half. AC Milan couldn't hold on. Once again, Rafael Leao's contribution across 90 minutes. There's always flashes of what he can do, but it has been the story around Rafael Leao all season, last season, and it looks like this season is going to be the same Rafael Leao. He might not be the one to blame solely, the defending from Tomori and Pavlovic. Defending set pieces has become a big conversation. The lack of proper defenders is being clear for all to see. If they cannot even defend a simple corner or a simple set piece, both goals scored by Liverpool were by defenders Konate and Virgil van Dijk. How do you leave Virgil van Dijk to space in a penalty box? I mean, considering how tall he is, it is crazy. Liverpool got away with it 3-1. Today, Manchester City, Erling Haaland, 9 goals so far in 4 games. 9 goals in 4 games. The last time any player of his caliber was able to do it is 2013, Luis Suarez, when he was at Liverpool. Man City, the almighty, is going to be in action today against Inter Milan at the Etihad Stadium. Thank you for tuning in to our first game. The Champions League is back with mouth-watering games. Club Brugge is also playing against Borussia Dortmund, who are no strangers to the Champions League, and newly promoted, one could say, very fresh babies into the Champions League. Girona from Spain. Girona is going to be in action against PSG, Paris Saint-Germain, Kylian Mbappe's former team. And speaking of Kylian Mbappe, he was also in action. There were so many games at the same time yesterday, and it has raised a lot of concern around why the Champions League had to change its format. And if you slice and you dice it, everything leads to the fact that they want to play more games so they can sell more tickets and make more money. But who is looking out for these footballers? First international break has gone down. There's a second one coming in October. Meanwhile, they are playing domestic leagues, playing Champions Leagues, playing Carabao Cup. Another useless tournament yesterday. Manchester United were in action against Barnsley. They beat Barnsley 7-0, and they are jubilating as if they won like a trophy. You're supposed to beat Barnsley. Barnsley plays in the championship team. A team of Manchester United's caliber should not be celebrating because they beat Barnsley, but that's how low the standards have fallen. Today, the other part of Manchester is going to be in action against Man City. Are they going to be able to get the job done against Inter Milan, pardon me, in the Champions League today, where Manchester City is playing against Inter Milan? Yesterday, Real Madrid, unconvincingly, the Kylian Mbappe era at Real Madrid, it hasn't started yet. Even though Jude Bellingham and Tchouaméni came back from injury, the performance on the field did not live up to what was expected. They got the victory 3-1 in the dying minutes from the young Brazilian kid, Henrik. But if you watch the game, it was very close. Stuttgart played really well. They should be proud of themselves. Playing against the current Champions League winner, Kylian Mbappe got a goal. But the fluidity and the chemistry between Mbappe, Rodrigo and Vinicius Jr., it hasn't really materialized yet. But if there's a coach, if there's a manager who has what it takes to do it, it is Carlo Ancelotti. Real Madrid beat Stuttgart, the German team, 3-1. Bayern Munich, Harry Kane was the conversation. They beat Dynamo Zagreb 9-2. That is what sparked the conversation, because some of the Champions League games, if you are being honest, right now as we're playing, Shakhtar Donetsk is playing Bologna. Some of it feels like Conference League, if you ask me. And the whole explanation for the changing of the format was to make room so that some of the big teams could play against each other early for the entertainment factor. Why is Dynamo Zagreb playing with Bayern Munich then? Harry Kane scored. It was embarrassing. At this level of the Champions League, I don't want to see a scoreline like 9-2. I mean, very good for Vincent Kompany, who many thought was like a championship low-level coach, and the job, Bayern job, was too big for him. So far, they have 5 games and 5 wins. So I'm happy for Vincent Kompany and Harry Kane breaking records, becoming the only English player to have scored 4 goals in the Champions League. He got 3 penalties in a game, another record. Dynamo Zagreb was very, very poor. So as Bayern Munich, I wouldn't be touting my horns or feeling too confident about their prospects this season based on beating Dynamo Zagreb 9-2. Very embarrassing game. It didn't match up to what is expected of a Champions League game. But I guess that's where we are now, where in the quest for more ticket sales and to make more money and get more advertising dollars, it might end up ruining the quality level of the game. But also, the injury rate is going to rise. Let's watch this season and see. But I for one, I'm not really impressed with what I saw. Maybe today, the Man City Inter Milan game is going to live up to its billing. Club Brugge is playing Dortmund, Girona, newbies in the Champions League. The Spanish little team found a way to miraculously make it to the top 4 in La Liga last season. They are playing in the Champions League for the first time against PSG, who are veterans of the Champions League themselves, never won it. Lost Neymar, lost Messi, lost Mbappe. Ousmane Dembele is in charge. Are they going to be able to finally lift the trophy that has escaped them for so many years? The Champions League is back and on track, delivering mouth-watering games. Thank you for tuning in to Asam Sports. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0. New Asam Music Collection, available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. The Forecast 2.0 is loading new music. But a channel coming soon. This has been Asam Sports. Tomorrow, Arsenal is going to be in action against Atalanta. That is going to be one for the books. Catch you tomorrow on Asam Sports. Happy hump day. Over and out.